My name is Mary Ann Stewart. I'm the parent representative on the elementary board of elementary and secondary education. We may or may not be joined by other board members, but I am sitting with my colleague from the department, Alyssa Hopkins. We've got a few other folks from the department here at the table. Patrick Buckwalter and Lee DiLorenzo. Kristen and Jeff are working on operations here on AV, so we thank them very much. You all received some guidelines for public comment. I'm just going to remind you that this meeting is being recorded so that my colleagues on the board will be able to review this public hearing. And today, I want to just note for the record, is Thursday, December 3rd, 2015. It's 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Just a few reminders. Everybody gets 3 minutes, at least to start out. We're saying 3 minutes. We're going to stick to that as closely as possible. So Alyssa is helping out here with the timer. You'll hear a warning, an indicator go off at 2 minutes and 30 seconds, meaning you have another 30 seconds. And then you'll hear another beep go off at a 3 minute mark. So wrap up your comments at that point, please. We hope to get to everybody, but we may not. There's quite a crowd here already, and we'll see how it goes. But just want to remind everyone that you can certainly submit comments to the department. You have the address on the guidelines page. But please send them in to the department by January 6th. Let's see. Is there anything else? Okay, so this is actually, I'm probably not going to ask questions or anything. It's really your opportunity to, and the public's opportunity to bring your comments forward so that the department and the board is aware of them. So with that, I'm going to get started. I would like to call, and I may not call in order that you signed up, just to get as broad a representation as possible, so please bear with me. I'd like to call Anthony Modica. And apologies in advance for mispronunciations. Let me just say, on deck, we'll put Kathleen Smith, Superintendent Kathleen Smith, and Michael J. Sullivan after Ms. Smith. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. My name is Anthony Modica. It's a pleasure and honor to be here. I'm on the board of New Heights. Representing New Heights in terms of what our vision is for the students from Brockton, Taunton, and Randolph. The mission is simple. You come to New Heights, you're going to college. Started the teaching experience in 1978, so I have a career that spans 5 decades, from a teacher to administrator, adjunct professor at Stonehill College, as well as Bridgewater. I think one of the inevitabilities of the 21st century, and I look at the students that had passed before me, is that you need one of two things to live the American dream. And when I look at the American dream, I'm thinking you need to understand about life, liberty, and owning property. You need a college education or you need a trade. I think those are very essential, and we're hyper-focused on the college education. The advantages of the college education, I can briefly summarize it in 5 bullets. Number one, college education provides more job opportunities in terms of flexibility. It's easy for you to get a job and keep a job because of the education, because of your communications, your computation skills. Number two, in the ever-changing economy and the climate that we're in, the unemployment rate for people with college educations is much lower, and if in fact you do get laid off, you're re-employed much faster. Your earning potential. The United States Department of Labor, the statistics indicate that you can expect to make in excess of $1 million more in your career of work if you have a college education than just a high school education. And that particular income earning potential is greatly enhances the community you live in, as well as the stability and security of your family. Another issue has to do with college education. Generally, people have more community engagement. They vote more, they volunteer more, they donate more to organizations in the community, keeping an eye on their real estate values. And I think that that particular issue is very important in terms of what our focus is. We're trying to give individuals an opportunity to be able to realize this potential, and our mission is a simple one. You come to New Heights, you go into college. And as I just highlighted in those 4 bullets, the particular potential for going to college and actually going to college greatly enhances the individual as well as the communities they live in. Last piece I think is also important is that generally individuals who have parents that went to college, generally the kids go to college, and we'd like to make sure that people that have an understanding about a college track that may not have had the advantage or the opportunity to go to college, the kids going to college, that will greatly enhance their stability as well as their security and their family as well. In conclusion, I thank you again. Looking forward to trying to make sure that this happens, and I think the vision is clear. And again, thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Modicum. Ms. Smith?
Good afternoon. Welcome to the City of Champions, Brockton. I'm Kathleen Smith. I'm the superintendent of the Brockton Public Schools, and I'm before you today to oppose this application. The Massachusetts Ed Reform Act of 1993 clearly called for the creation of charter schools to collaborate with public school districts. They were to share best practices and fill unmet community needs with innovative initiatives and solutions. I've reviewed the New Heights application thoroughly. Neither requirement applies. On the one hand, we are a nationally recognized leader in urban education with 17,000 plus students in grades pre-K to 12. Of those, 80% are low income, 36% report their first language not English, 13% are special education services. Yet the International Center for Leadership and Education has named Brockton High a model school every year since 2003, while U.S. News and World Reports has designated it a model school five times. We are still the only urban school district without a level four school. On the other hand, there is New Heights application, which was originally crafted for a district struggling at the high school level. After two rejections in one community and another one here in Brockton last year, it's clear the proposal offers a solution to a problem that does not exist here. We have seven excellent middle schools offering something for every student. People move here for educational opportunities and then watch their children succeed as they progress through high school. Our student growth percentile for high stakes testing is strong in grades 6 through 8, while composite performance index is typically the highest among large urban districts. Our International Baccalaureate Academy prepares students for high school and college success. Valued Arts and other collaborations with Bridgewater State University, Stonehill College. Students study financial literacy with Empowering Yourself programs, win national state competitions. We have student government, drama, music, chorus, band, jazz band, school newspaper, peer mediators, after school programs, intramurals, transitions to high school programs. Our award-winning high school is recognized by leading researcher Ron Ferguson and Pedro Naguera for defying demographics and reducing the achievement gap, and has abundant opportunities for this diverse population. We lead in high academics and college readiness with advanced placement courses from advanced physics to calculus, international baccalaureate continued from the middle school to high school, other dual enrollment programs for college credits, Gateway to College with Massasoit, our Pathway Center, which offers Massasoit courses with Massasoit professors. Our Youth Career Connect STEM program working with the Brockton Area Workforce Development Board. As a result, 92% of Brockton's 4,000 plus high school graduates go on to college. And this year, 291 students earned the John and Abigail Adams scholarships for excellence in the state's MCAS exam. Taking a holistic approach to the whole student, we again provide, as I said, award-winning drama, music, arts, two swimming pools, state-of-the-art ice rink, Marciano and Rock Stadium, both located on campus, and dozens upon dozens of clubs, competitive athletics programs, which sweep the state championships routinely. And this is just some of what we offer. For families who want something else, choices are varied. From our alternative schools, including the Goddard Therapeutic Day School, Champion Academy, where students earn a competency-based diploma with dual enrollment component at the college level. Our success at reducing the achievement gap is undeniable. Nobody does it better as a result of carefully crafted, individualized learning and teaching initiatives and academic supports at all levels. Highly trained, innovative administrators and educators who are licensed in the fields they teach. All of these individuals are deeply committed to our students, families, academically, socially, and emotionally. And in closing, in approving the New Heights Charter School application, it will undermine a district with quality schools. We are not a broken school system. We are already working miracles with lean resources, and there is no reason to shake that foundation by allowing this untested charter school to enter our city. Thank you.
Thank you, Superintendent Smith. Mr. Sullivan. And can we have on deck Mr. Buckley? That would be Bob Buckley, please. And Nick Palancas. Many apologies. Mr. Sullivan.
Thank you very much, Ms. Stewart. Again, welcome to the city of Brockton. I'm here in support of the New Heights Charter School application to have a charter school in the city of Brockton to support the community of Brockton, Randolph, and Taunton. I'm going to really talk about, in my 3 minutes, why charter schools generally, why a charter school in Brockton, and then why the New Heights Charter School should be awarded the opportunity to participate. First off, my support of charter schools goes back, interestingly, to the date of 1993 when I served on the House Education Committee and served on the conference committee that actually drafted and got passed the Act to Improve Public Education. My support of the Act to Improve Public Education in 1993 is really part of the whole issue of empowerment and high standards. I saw a significant gap between the haves and the have-nots as it related to choice. I grew up in a lower middle class family in the community right next to the city of Brockton, the town of Holbrook, one of seven. And two of us had the opportunity to essentially have the benefit of both public education and private education. I think that every family in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts should have the opportunity of choice. I applaud the leadership of Superintendent Smith. I think Brockton essentially turns out extraordinary students. But the fact of the matter is, not every child in the city of Brockton gets everything they want from the Brockton school system. And I think particularly lower income families that don't have the opportunity for choice should have the opportunity of a charter school here in the city of Brockton. I don't know why a Brockton public school system that feels so confident and proud of its accomplishments would be fearful of a few hundred families that determine that the best interest of their kids rest in a charter school. So charter schools generally, I think, are an important opportunity for middle income, lower middle income, in the poorest families to essentially be empowered with choice. Why a charter school in Brockton? Because Brockton doesn't have one presently. And I think a charter school in Brockton just further empowers the families. In fact, why New Heights Charter School? Why am I affiliated with New Heights Charter School? Because essentially their philosophy. Their interest is to target those same communities that I worked very closely with when I was a district attorney here in Plymouth County. The neighborhoods that required really the most need and the most support. They know that within those communities, within those neighborhoods, there are families and kids that would benefit from the opportunity for a much smaller environment, a charter school, where maybe the rules and regulations aren't quite the same as they are with the Brockton public school system. This is not a question that the Brockton public school system is a failed system, and in fact, it's not. Superintendent Smith talked about 92% go on to college, but the fact of the matter is it's not 100%, and some kids drop out, and I think that's the worst that we can do as adults in terms of public policy. Kids have an opportunity, I think constitutionally, to have an education here in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, and I think the New Heights Charter School will provide an opportunity for those families that feel that they're underserved presently. So thank you.
Mr. Sullivan. Mr. Buckley.
Thank you very much. My name is Bob Buckley. I'm the Chief of Staff for Mayor Bill Carpenter. The mayor is out of the country this week, but he has asked me to read this statement into the public record on his behalf. My name is Bill Carpenter, and I am the proud mayor of the city of Brockton. One of the things I am most proud of as mayor is the quality of education provided to the young people of Brockton by the Brockton Public Schools. There are plenty of educators, parents, students, and alumni who will speak here today about the quality of education already available to Brockton students. The educational opportunities available at Brockton High are nationally recognized by such media outlets as Newsweek, U.S. World News Report, and the New York Times. There are programs for every child, from international baccalaureate programs and advanced placement to the establishment of the Edison Academy and our Pathways programs designed to help re-engage our dropouts into the educational system. The high school's drama, arts, music, and athletic departments are second to none. City students are also offered the opportunity of a vocational education with a strong academic curriculum at Southeastern Regional Vocational, where two-thirds of the student body is Brockton residents. These are just a few of the many wonderful examples as to why Brockton is considered a model in an urban educational experience. Alternative schools do play a role in today's educational experience. However, these alternative schools must offer something the public school system does not currently offer. An example of this would be Independence Academy, the Commonwealth's fourth recovery high school located here in Brockton. Independence Academy helps students with substance abuse issues re-engage their education in a setting that provides recovery support. The proposed charter school offers no educational option not already provided by the Brockton Public Schools. It should also be noted that Brockton would not even be under consideration as a site for the latest New Heights charter proposal if the proponents had not sidestepped the eligibility requirements by adding Randolph and Taunton to this year's application. This proposal is no more than a recycled version of the New Heights charter school proposal rejected last year and now trying to circumvent DESE's own eligibility regulations. I stand ready to work with the proponents of a Brockton charter school that would actually increase educational opportunities for Brockton students. New Heights is not such a proposal. It is the wrong school at the wrong time in the wrong community. Respectfully, I ask the board to reject this application. Thank you.
Mr. Palantras, please correct me.
It's Nick Palantras.
I'm sorry, before you start, I would like to have on deck Jody Alameda and Tiara Washington. You can get ready. You can stand up behind when you hear the timer go off at 2:30. Go ahead.
Yeah, good afternoon. My name is Nick Palantras. I'm the Senior Vice President of Massasoit Community College. And on behalf of President Charles Wall, who is not able to attend this evening, I'd like to welcome you all at the Conference Center of Massasoit Community College. We are pleased to host this opportunity for the community to discuss the proposed New Heights Charter School. Massasoit Community College has established a productive and innovative collaboration with a proposed New Heights Charter School in which we will serve as the higher education partner for its early college programming. The school students enrolled in grades 6th through 10th grade will focus on developing the knowledge and skills necessary to succeed in college. Students in the 11th and 12th grade who are assessed as college ready will take dual enrollment courses at Massasoit and begin work towards a degree. We are working closely with the New Heights Charter School proposers to ensure that its mathematics and writing courses align directly with Massasoit's curricula, positioning students for transition into credit-bearing coursework at Massasoit. Massasoit is committed to providing more opportunities for students in our service area to benefit from dual enrollment to help manage the cost of college education and fulfill our mission to offer accessible and innovative programs with comprehensive support services to prepare students for membership in a global society. Our long-standing collaboration with the Brockton Public Schools continues to grow. Additionally, we continue to expand our existing dual enrollment programs in several districts, including Bridgewater-Raynham, Randolph, and Middleborough. Our Gateway to College program had its largest graduating class ever in June 2015 and continue to increase the numbers of districts it serves. And our new veterinary technology program has developed a partnership with Norfolk County Agricultural High School to share facilities and offer early college dual enrollment opportunities for students in that service area. We look forward to continuing these and other efforts to enable our students to achieve educational success. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I'm Jody Almeida, a member of the Taunton School Committee. I've served on the school committee for 28 years. And in that time, I have been a proponent of public education. We service our children with less money than it takes for a charter school to service the children. We need to look at that. In that time, we have developed an alternative high school. We've put libraries in every single school. We have technology program. We have foreign languages, added foreign language, extra foreign languages to our programs. We have a lot of students that take advanced placement classes. There is no way that we are not servicing our students. Recently, we did a Chapter 74. We offer alternative programs for our high school students that gives them vocational training. And we have the highest graduation rate in history in Taunton. We have students that are going to colleges like Harvard, Princeton, Yale. We can service our students without having to send them to a charter school. Charter school takes money away from public education, and that's the thing that bothers me the most. We have all kinds of programs at our high school, after-school programs. We are in the process now. We're just discussing the possibility of doing an innovative school in our middle school. So I think we can service our students as well as any charter school. So I am opposed to a charter school in Brockton. I am opposed that Taunton students would be able to attend that school, taking public money for private education. Thank you.
Tiara Washington. And let me have on deck, please, Gloria Cho, Claire Cronin. That's good for now.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Tiara Washington. I am here because I am a resident and a former student of Brockton High. I see the need for a charter school that will help prepare students for college in our community. The point I want to make today is that we are here and ready to answer the call for our community. I talk to parents and community members on a day-to-day basis, and they are desperate for change and choice. I've heard stories of parents who get up at 5 a.m. to drive their children to schools or transport them for more than 30 minutes away. I've heard stories from several students that have been denied access to Brockton High, the main high school, and have to attend alternative schools. They've described their experience as surviving just to make it through to graduate. We have been through the process, and it has been crucial for our growth. Last year, we were not chartered, but we are back again, not just because we want it, but because we also believe in choice and we need it. Every day, I'm meeting between 20 to 30 parents who are frustrated because their needs are not being met. They don't have any other choice but to send their children to schools outside of Brockton and Randolph and other local communities. Of the several parents I've met, some are here and will speak today who have their children enrolled at Foxborough Regional Charter School. All the parents who are here today in support of New Heights are here to make a point of getting their voices heard. The community needs this and they want New Heights Charter School. I speak with the parents every single day. I'm out there. I'm a community outreach coordinator. And seeing them and hearing their voices almost brings tears to my eyes because I know what it feels like to be a part of a situation where parents are desperate and want this for their children. We have over 500 letters of support that show this, and nearly 600 applicants to show this from this local area. And we're now developing recruitment strategies for Taunton that will begin next week. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Gloria Cho, and I'm an English language acquisition coach for bilingual ESL services for Brockton Public Schools and a proud resident of Brockton. I'm here to express my strong opposition to the New Heights Charter School application with focus on the needs of English language learners. First of all, I would like to mention that not only does Brockton Public Schools offer what the New Heights Charter School proposes, we offer more. We are already utilizing the data and assessment tools, curriculum design model, and intervention models that the New Heights Charter School is planning on using. When it comes to teacher training and support, we already have common planning time, ongoing professional development, and instructional coaching. What bothers me most about this application is what I did not find. English language learners are definitely not a priority if you don't provide families and students any access. Where are the bilingual counselors? Where are the bilingual paraprofessional supports? Where are the bilingual community facilitators? As I reviewed their curriculum, including college credit courses, there's no specific course designed with a consideration of English language learners. The instructors who will provide college credit courses are not properly trained for sheltered English instruction. New Heights Charter School does not capitalize on our English language learners' native languages. Research conclusively demonstrates the importance of utilizing students' native languages to provide access to grade-level curriculum while they're learning English in academic settings. Brockton Public Schools provides native language supports through teachers and support teachers, bilingual counselors, bilingual community facilitators, and bilingual parent advocates. Brockton does not just provide interpreters. We offer professional development for parents in their native languages. Our bilingual advocates actively engage families and parents who need support in navigating the public school system. And we offer English language classes for parents in the evenings. Brockton has been utilizing the strengths of our community to prepare for the 21st century. That is the difference between us. These specialized supports for English language learners make a difference in our student outcomes. I'll include specific data about our students' success in my written testimony. For all these aforementioned reasons, I strongly oppose the granting of the charter for the New Heights Charter School, as it will not offer any program for English language learners that students are not currently receiving within the Brockton Public Schools. Thank you very much for taking your time to listen.
Thank you. Representative Claire Cronin, followed by State Senator Michael Brady, and let me have Carolina Evra on deck.
Good afternoon. Thank you for allowing me the opportunity to testify before you today, and thank you for the work that you do on behalf of students in the Commonwealth. My name is Claire Cronin. I am the state representative for the 11th Plymouth District, which represents parts of Brockton and the town of Easton as well. I'm the vice chair of the Judiciary Committee and a member of the Ways and Means Committee. I stand before you today as a proud graduate of the Brockton school system, where I attended grades 1-12. The education I received from this wonderful and all-inclusive school system provided me with the foundation that allowed me to successfully pursue a college and then a law school education. We are not here today to debate the merits of charter schools in general. Many will acknowledge that in certain circumstances, charters may serve and fill a need for some students in the Commonwealth. However, that is not the case in the city of Brockton. By the same token, there are only a limited number of charters. Granting this application would be a disservice to other communities in the Commonwealth that might in fact be well served by a charter school. The New Heights Charter School fails to meet the most basic criteria set forth by the Mass Charter School regulations. 603 CMR 1.043C requires that the charter school demonstrate the ability to meet its enrollment projections through demonstration of strong support for the charter school in the community. The demand for this proposed charter school simply does not exist in Brockton. I have served for 3 years. I have knocked on hundreds of doors. I talk to constituents every day of the week, and never has this been brought before me. Conversely, I frequently hear about the strength of our wonderful school system, and I am constantly bombarded with requests to continue and push for continuous funding for our very own schools. 603 CMR 1.043F and Mass General Laws Chapter 71, Section 89 define that the purpose of a charter school is to enhance options of schools for students and parents within and outside of their school district. The New Heights Charter School fails to offer an alternative program that is not already available to the students in Brockton. There are currently technical schools and private academies in Brockton and existing charter schools in surrounding communities. New Heights Charter School's mission is to prepare students for college, but there is no evidence that these programs have a higher success rate of preparing students for colleges than the Brockton High School. The granting of this application is a risky proposition for both the students of Brockton and for your department as well. We remember very well what happened in Gloucester. Brockton High School has a proven record of effectively preparing its students for college, offering advanced placement courses, dual enrollment programs to earn college credit. 92% of Brockton High School graduates go on to college in a district where 81% of our students live below the poverty level. It is abundantly clear that this charter lacks the required community support for the granting of the application. More importantly, the need for the proposed charter does not exist in the city of Brockton. Brockton Public Schools are a model of excellence in urban education. Brockton High School was named one of America's best high schools by U.S. News and World Report. And this past year, 291 students earned the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship for Excellence on the MCAS. As you consider this proposal, I ask that you consider the mission statement of the Department of Elementary and Secondary Education, which is to strengthen the Commonwealth's public education system so that every student is prepared to succeed in post-secondary education, compete in the global economy, and understand the rights and responsibilities of American citizens, and in doing so, to close all proficiency gaps. I can assure you that the approval of this application would undermine the very mission that DESE is required to uphold. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Representative Cronin. State Senator Michael Brady, please.
Thank you, and I want to thank you for all the work you do as well. My name is Mike Brady. I'm a state senator from the 2nd Plymouth-Bristol area, which includes the city of Brockton. This isn't the first time we've been here with a proposal for a charter school of this kind trying to come into Brockton. I am also a proud and honored graduate of Brockton High School class of 1980, and I also attended the public school system grades 1 through 12 in the city of Brockton. Brockton is doing better than it ever has with our public school system, a lot better than when I was there, and they're continuing to do a great job and achieve great achievements throughout the system. They're sending more children on to college with the Abigail Adams Scholarships than ever before, and they're continuing to offer choices, and we do offer choices here in Brockton through the Catholic Academy we have, Southeastern Regional, and some of the towns around us are taking Brockton students. So we offer plenty of choices. We have a number one ROTC program. We have advanced placement courses, international reevaluation, and we're continuing to offer many choices to the students in Brockton. And as my colleague, Representative Claire Cronin, mentioned, I have knocked on thousands and thousands of doors in this district, and not one parent has ever asked me to bring a charter school into the city of Brockton. If other communities need a charter school because their test scores are lower, they're having trouble, you know, that all well-being they can offer to these communities. But I feel strongly that the only reason they're coming to Brockton is because of financial situation, because Brockton struggles every day, but we work every day to get funding from our state, and we get more than other communities because of the diverse population we have in Brockton, because we teach every child to the fullest of their ability. And I know that Other communities and towns may not get the funding Brockton does, but that's besides the population, our diverse population, and we have 97,000-plus residents in the city of Brockton. So I want to continue to offer my strong opposition to this proposed charter school. We did have a charter school in Brockton at one point, and it was going to fail, so it could absorb by the Brockton public school system. And I am very concerned about these charter schools coming into our communities trying to go after the funding. And that's my biggest concern. And I have also filed legislation at the state level to not allow for-profit charter schools. So if they cared about the children, they wouldn't be looking to make a profit. And I, again, am in strong opposition to this. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator Brady. And I have Carolina Evera, please. And on deck, Pascale St. Cyr and Eunice Velasi. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Mirandolina Evora, and I am a very proud parent of a student in the Brockton High, which I consider the high school of champions. And I would like to thank you, Brockton High School. My child is a very special child. He was born very premature with only 24 months gestation, and with 400 grams. I'm sorry, I get every time I get very emotional talking about this. And he got, thank God, all the support at Brockton Public School. And I do believe that there is no other school coming after Brockton school, Public School, that is going to provide all the services that our community needs, even because we are living in a multicultural, bilingual society, students coming from every different countries, and the Brockton Public School fortunately provide all these bilingual facilitators who reach out to make sure we can participate in school events and meetings. They discuss experience and the service with Brockton Public School, both academic and non-academic teacher and paraprofessionals who speak my language and who are trained to help my child learn English and the content area. Bilingual counselors, translation of documents, two-way program, medical interpretation programs, sports, music, summer programs, cell seat, college preparation programs, BSU programs, etc. So I do believe that experience counts. Brockton Public School has many years, I don't know how many years, but I can tell that it's many years for all these champions that Brockton has grown already. So I'm a very proud parent of Brockton Public School, where my child is attending school. And I do believe that no one wants to spend more money for less service. I'm very grateful for Brockton Public School. Mm-hmm.
Pascale St. Cyr, please. I think that goes to the microphone. Yeah.
Good afternoon. My name is Pascale St. Cyr. I am from Haiti, but I'm a citizen of Brockton. I used to live in Florida, and I'm surprised to see that some people like oppose to a charter school, because in Florida, they have approximately two charter schools in each city. So because over there, I think they see charter school as a complement to public schools. I don't think charter schools ought to compete with public schools. They are here to complete them. That's what I think. Because in my family, I have many nephews and nieces. They have to go all the way to Foxborough to go to a charter school. So I think we need to have more choices. So it's your right to have more choices. So that's why I'm here. I'm here as a citizen of Brockton, as a Tati, because my nieces and youth, because my son, they went to Brockton High School. They're good students too, but we need more choices here. That's why I'm supporting the application. And another thing too, I am a ESOL coordinator, like English to speaker of other languages. Charter school, they offer services for them too, good services. So because I work in Florida as with charter school student, with public school student, they have approximately the same services. So I don't know. I don't think charter schools are a threat to public schools. So that's it.
And let me have Superintendent Julie Hackett on deck, and maybe, how about Jessica Mello?
Hello, my name is Eunice Belisi, and I am a former resident of Brockton, Massachusetts. I lived here between the years of 2010 to 2013, and I still currently have family members who live out here in Brockton. I am supporting the New Heights Public Charter School for various different reasons. Number one, I have relatives who would want to put their children in a smaller classroom environment, but are not able to. I have family members and close friends who have no choice but to drive their children to the local public schools, and their biggest complaint is that their child is in a classroom with 35 other students. I believe that a charter school would provide an option for smaller classroom size. I am for the charter school because in the time that I've been doing community outreach, I have spoken to frustrated parents. Not only are they frustrated because of the environment the school is in, they are frustrated because they feel like their child is another number in a bigger system. I'm for this charter school because I believe that every single parent who lives in this city is allowed to have a choice. Whether your choice is to put your son or daughter in the Brockton public school system, or send them to a private school, or to put them to a charter school. Having a charter school in Brockton would not take away anything from this city. It would just add. It would give parents what they feel is best for their child. By taking away the choice that a mom or dad has for their child, you are telling that parent that Brockton has the right to choose for your child. As a parent, it should be your choice whether you choose to enroll your son or daughter in a local public school, a local private school, or a local charter school. I have spoken to parents who feel that not only can they not connect with their child's teacher, but they feel as if their child goes the entire year from September to June without knowing what they should know, without learning what they should learn. I recently spoke to a father who said that he walked into one of the local junior highs and said that his teacher barely knows him because his teacher has to focus on crowd management and behavior management during a class period. I believe that this charter school would offer parents choices, and the key word is choices. Having more choices does not take away from what Brockton already has. It just gives parents, no matter what your income level, no matter where, what country you are originally from, no matter whether you speak English as a first language or not, it should give each and every parent who lives in this city the choice to enroll their child in the school of that they want them to be in. We are offering choices. We're not looking to take away. We're looking to add. Thank you.
Thank you. Superintendent Hackett?
Hello, my name is Julie Hackett. I am the superintendent of schools in Taunton, where I've been for the last 8 years. I am also the newly elected vice president of the Massachusetts Association of School Superintendents. And for the record, I'm a strong believer in accountability and in charter schools in districts that aren't getting the job done. But we are getting the job done in Taunton. And for that matter, so are our friends in Brockton and in many other school communities in Massachusetts. Traditional district schools, if you will, often get a bad rap because we're seen as lacking the desire or ability to innovate or personalize education for our students. So I thought I'd share with you the story of Taunton. Back some time ago, a number of years ago, our dropout rate was around 7%. Our graduation rate was around 60-something percent, and the expectations for students in college were limited. Financial struggles intensified, teachers and educational assistants were laid off, we had to close 5 schools, we redistricted not once but twice, we consolidated 8th grade into the high school, making it the 5th largest high school in Massachusetts. Fast forward to today, which is almost a decade or so later, and we now have the lowest dropout rate in our history at 1.7% in the district and less than 1.1%, excuse me, at the high school. Our graduation rate is the highest in our history at over 90%. We were recognized by the Pioneer Institute for closing achievement gaps at a rate that's 2 to 3 times faster than the state. And just yesterday, I received notification from the Department of Elementary and Secondary Education that researchers from Harvard selected Taunton as a best practices district for our academic achievements with respect to our high needs learners. I heard the gentleman speak earlier who said that kids will go to college if they go to New Heights Charter School. We may be a traditional district school, but we mean it when we say post-secondary pursuits for all. In fact, in a community where only 18% of our residents have bachelor's degrees or higher compared to 39% statewide, we've managed to increase the number of college-bound students by more than 5% in the past few years, and we have increased our Tier 1 college acceptances to some fantastic universities throughout the country. We have a strong partnership with Bristol Community College that spans decades. We have unique partnerships with Bridgewater State University, Stonehill College, and many others. All our middle schools have partnerships with area colleges, and we bring students to college campuses starting in 7th grade. We're proud to offer free PSAT tests, free AP tests. In the past year alone, we've nearly doubled our participation rates on AP and tripled the number of test takers. Many of our students get qualifying scores on AP exams, and they can enter college with 1 or 2 years of college under their belts. We have dual enrollment. The list goes on. I want to mention to you that one of the concerns that I have is why we're here in the first place, and it makes no sense that the geographic reach for New Heights is in Taunton. Taunton is not a city that you envisioned, I believe, as a Board of Ed when you thought about the bottom 10%. And the bottom 10% is a seriously flawed methodology. The percentage of Taunton students in advanced on the MCAS was 25 times higher than Lawrence in ELA, 30% higher in math, and 3 times higher in science. I point this out because we dropped from spot number 50 down to the bottom 10% somehow through statistical maneuvers that we don't completely understand. But these are the statistics that relate to our concerns. The percent of Lawrence's students in Warning was twice Taunton's in both ELA and science, and about 25% higher in math. Lawrence gained 2 points on Taunton in ELA, but it would take them 6 years to catch up to us in Taunton, assuming they continued to gain 2 points on Taunton each year. Yeah. In science, Lawrence gained 1 point on Taunton, but they would need 14 years to catch up at the same rate. My point is that this is a flawed system. It needs some time before we start approving more charter schools that will ultimately hurt our children in the public schools. Kids should have a constitutional right to attend an outstanding school, and if New Heights' proposal passes Taunton, kids will be robbed of that opportunity. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Carolina Evra is still in the room. She can speak after this student.
Good afternoon. My name is Jessica Mallow. English is my second language, and my experience in Taunton High School is good. When I first got to Taunton High School 3 years ago, I had no English at all. I was nervous at first, but everyone showed my comfort and helped me. EL class helped me a lot. It was a good start to learn how to speak, write, and listen in English. Everyone was really good and helpful. We should help everyone when they need it. It's not easy coming to a country without speaking a word. So when people offer help, we should be helpfully grateful. I think being surrounded by native English speakers is very helpful. I plan to go to college for criminal justice or to be a pediatrician. Thank you very much.
Carolina, are you here? Thank you.
Let's Hello, my name is Carlina Ivara. I'm a student at Brockton High School that supports the proposed New Heights Charter School. I must admit that I'm a little nervous to speak to you today, but I thought it was important that you had the chance to hear from a local high school student who supports bringing a charter public school to Brockton. I have friends who struggle to succeed with their coursework, some because they're not learning English fast enough or well enough to keep up, and some who say they get easily distracted because the classes are large. I understand that charter public schools often have smaller class sizes, more intensive ELL classes, and longer school days, all of which would have been really helpful to my friends and probably for me as well. Since I arrived in this country from Cape Verde, I've always done well in school. You might wonder why a student who has apparently done well at Brockton High School would be here to speak in favor of a charter public school. It's a fair question. First, I need you to know that I very much appreciate and respect the teachers that I've had. I know that they are doing their best, and I feel like I have been one of the lucky ones when I look at the statistics of how other BHS students are doing. In preparing to speak to you today, I have had lots of different thoughts running through my mind. Mostly, I want to speak up for those students who are getting lost in the system because they are new to this country, don't speak English very well, and do not have parents who understand how the school works here. To me, they are friends and neighbors, and I think they deserve the very best chance to succeed and contribute to this society. Most of their parents risked leaving everything they knew to bring their children to US, where they could get a good education and have a better life. Why not give them a chance to pick a choice? I strongly support the idea of bringing a charter public school here so that those families who want to choose something different will have that chance. New Heights students will be pushed and held to high expectations, and they will need to put a lot of hours if they are to make it. All eyes will be on them to prove that kids from Brockton, no matter where they were born or the color of their skin or how much money their parents earn, won't stop them of going to college. New Heights Charter School will ensure your child has access to college courses for free, and they will make sure that students are given the support for success in their college coursework. Brockton families deserve a choice. All of Brockton families deserve access to college. Brockton families deserve a charter school. Thank you.
Thank you for your testimony. I'm going to call the next few people, and then I'm going to, we've been joined by a couple of people up here at the table, and I just want to take a moment to acknowledge them. So Maria Andrade and Magli Vincente, and let's see, how about Jerry Cassidy? If you can prepare to come up first, Maria, then Magli, and then Jerry. And joined by Penny Noyes.
I'm Penny Noyce from Boston. Thanks for coming.
And that's also Cliff Chuang, who is joining us from the department as well. Okay, go ahead, please.
My name is Martini Andrade. Mai di Carla Amado, studente di East Middle School. Minha filha vem de Calverde sem saber nada de inglês. E graças a East Middle Schools, de professores brilhantes e grandes educadores, Cossin Carla te domina inglês direito, extra na high school, ele quadro de honra na high school.
Just for the record, my name is Augusto Martins, one of the many community relations facilitators for the Brockton Public Schools. My name is Augusto Martins, just for the record, one of the many community relations facilitators for the Brockton Public Schools. My name is Martina Andrade, Carla Amado's mother. She has been here for 3 years. She's now at Brockton High School, freshman. She came with no English, started her sixth grade at East Middle School. She's equally fluent in all languages, both languages. She is doing extremely well, highest honor this term, and she's planning to go to college thanks to all the good work that she had at East Middle School.
Minha filha gosta em quadro de honra na high school, graça middle school. A minha contra child school, para modo se te priva outros meninos de prende, modem a filha prende.
She is highest honor student at Brockton High School. I'm against the charter school because this way other students will not be successful as my daughter is at this time at the Brockton High School.
Child school se te priva outros meninos de prende, modem a filha prende. E moda atividades que se tem lá educativo, se child school bem abre, que as atividades educativas está parte.
If this charter school will be approved, most of the program that Brockton High School has will not be in session, and that, of course, will impact on student learning academics.
Obrigado, East Middle School. Obrigado, professores de East Middle School e direção de East Middle School para ajudar minha filha. Thank you.
Thank you to all Brockton Public School, special East Middle School, for helping my child to learn English, being successful, and then plan to go to college and probably Harvard if she continues at Brockton High School.
Thank you for your testimony. Madeline Vincente.
I'm reading for Maglie a letter. You're welcome. Good afternoon. My name is Maglie Vincent. I am in support of New Heights Charter School. I am a concerned and frustrated Brockton parent. I have a daughter who is in Brockton Public Schools, yet I believe charter schools are the best choice. My family and I are very excited about the prospect of having a new high-quality public school come into our community. As parents, we are concerned about our children performing at grade level. As a parent, I want the best education for my child in a charter school. I know my daughter will have a complete education while receiving college prep classes that will help prepare her to have a good career and a better life. We should not be restricted to the choices we can make. We need a charter school in Brockton. For too long, families and parents like me have had no choices. Today, I am calling on the Department of Elementary and Secondary Education to revive the application for new Brockton Charter Schools so I can decide where I want to send my children to school. Thank you.
And could I please have, And if Maria Andrade is here. Oh, so you spoke for her. Yeah, okay, thank you very much. No, it's fine. Thank you, go ahead, please.
Thank you, I'm Jerry Cassidy. I'm a third generation Brocktonian. My wife and I have gone through the Brockton public school systems, as my two kids have, and they've graduated. I think we should change the slogan of Brockton, as the opening line said, mission is simple, go to Brockton High, go to college. 92% of the kids in Brockton go off to college. Both of my kids are graduated a few years ago, and they're actively working now. I'm totally against charter schools. Would add to lots of layoffs, and also would like to say my friend Tom Kennedy, who is the icon here in Brockton, he would definitely be opposed to this charter school proposal. So saying that, I just want to say thank you.
Thank you for your testimony. So I don't think I called anybody up ready. So could I have Gloria Rubilar next, and followed by Jean Meck, or Jean Meck, and Shayna Barnes after that. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Gloria Rubilar. I'm a proud resident of this city. I'm a parent of four students that have graduated through Brockton High School. I'm also a guidance counselor. So I would like to say to everyone, buenas noches, buena noite. I'm a bilingual counselor as well. I'm very proud of the work that Brockton Public Schools does, and specifically about the work that we do at Brockton High School. As a I was a teacher at Brockton High for many years. As I said, I'm a parent, but I'm a guidance, as a guidance counselor, I also have had the opportunity to see and help many students. One of the things that called my attention about the poster of the charter schools is the early college design program. One thing that maybe you need to hear from me is that students that come to Brockton High School in ninth grade, during the first month already, they meet with us and we have sessions with them, some workshops about early college planning. We make sure that every student understands what is ahead of them, what do they need to do. And we make sure that every student also has a personalized educational plan that leads to that and is assessed regularly. Students don't meet with us only once, but many times throughout the year. We have sessions with them. We have also offered sessions with the parents. And our principal make phone calls home to make sure that the parents also are aware of all the things that they need to do in order to participate in the sessions and workshops that we offer to them, to the parents for support. One thing that I also would like to mention is that many people have talked about the 92% of students that are going to colleges. We are very proud of that. But as a vocational and career counselor, I'm also very proud of that other 8%. That other 8% of students also go to something else. Our students sometimes decide to go into the trades, or as a vocational students, they're the ones that I work with, they decide to go to vocational schools or continue working right after schools. But it's a personal decision. Of course, it's not always a personal decision. Sometimes it's a decision about finances that I can see will also with other families, or families that are also not eligible for financial aid for different reasons. But we make sure that every single student, every guidance counselor in Brockton High, make sure that every single student have a post-secondary plan. In addition to that, we make sure that every student in our school also have a college preparatory education. Every single student in Brockton High receives a college preparatory education, so they have the minimum, at least, requirements to move into college in the future. Our students are in AP courses, dual enrollment, and many of them are already ahead of the game as IB students, full IB students with many college courses under their belt as they leave the high school. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hi, thank you for letting me speak. My name is Jean Mack, and I'm here to oppose the application for the charter school. I'm the mother to a set of 18-year-old twins in college who graduated from Brockton High School earlier this year. My children have been in four different schools in the city. I was a volunteer at each school and part of several volunteer committees in each building. I'm a one-to-one paraprofessional to a special needs high school student and volunteer with several local community committees. Due to my profession and community involvement, I've had the opportunity to work with students, families, and staff from almost, if not all, of the schools in the city. I applaud New Heights Charter Group for their aspirations, but have to agree with many of my friends, coworkers, acquaintances, and family, and that this group is not necessary or prepared to start here in Brockton, as far as I can tell. New Heights is not only not offering anything new that our public school system doesn't have, but again, like last year, they're lacking in a clear plan addressing our ELL and special needs populations. Brockton High does not ask the kids if they want to go to college. Brockton High teaches the kids what they need for when they go to college. If I had a dollar for every time I heard a staff member tell a child this, I'd have enough money to go on a cruise to someplace warm. According to New Heights' own website, listed in the executive summary, Fast Track High Schools offer personalized plans for each student, reaching underserved student populations, including students from families without college experience, low-income English language learners, and students of color, with a See More link site connected to that statement. Besides because Brockton has a very high ELL, low-income families, and student of color populations, I clicked on the link. I found nothing on that link that addressed any of those issues. Which children in Brockton go to college has very little to do with where they live in our city, how little money the family has, or the color of their skin. Any child who's willing to put in the work and take the classes gets the same benefit. So although I'm sure New Heights has good intentions, we all know where that road usually leads to. Brockton Public Schools offer such a variety of learning techniques and dedication to children and their families that my husband and I turned down an opportunity to privately educate our children. Brockton has several different choices for a high school education that will, as long as the student desires an education, provide several different choices for high school and provide them with the tools that they need to go to college. I have several friends and acquaintances whose children have received many credits from colleges for the advanced classes offered at Brockton High. In my professional observations, it's not the lack of a quality education, effort, or assistance that hinders our children from getting further in their education. It's often the children's lack of perseverance and or assistance outside the academic building. New Heights can't fix that. A charter school will only serve to further burden the finances of Brockton Public Schools, its staff, and ultimately the city, because New Heights isn't going to give Brockton Public Schools back the monies necessary for us to educate the children they deem unworthy of their program any longer and send back to us. Brockton is not underperforming. Brockton has choices. Brockton has national recognition for its quality education. Brockton is always working to better its system. Brockton is already ahead of the game. If Brockton doesn't want or need New Heights, why force it on us?
Thank you very much. City Councilor at Large, Shayna Barnes, followed by Tony Saunders and Rick Schwartz. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for hearing us today. My name is Shayna Barnes. I am a city councilor at large here in Brockton, and I won't be before you long. I just have a few things that I want to say personally and then some facts that I wanted to present to you. So just first to be clear, I'm not against the idea of a charter school. I was actually on Champion Charter Board of Trustees in 2008 until they were absorbed by the Brockton Public Schools. So at the time, it was something necessary that we needed. And then it was found to be obsolete at that particular time. And that was 8 years ago, 8 or 9 years ago. So if you're saying that Brockton Public Schools are in the same position that we were 8 years ago, I would argue that. And I would argue that any of that information would be further investigated. Our administration and our teachers, I believe in them 100%. They work daily to make sure that our children are educated to the highest standards available, and they keep us competitive in these global markets. And I really appreciate their efforts every single day in doing that. Several people have said earlier that there's no evidence in the achievement goals that the charter school claims to say that they're going to produce. And I would ask you to take a look at that as well and take a look at what we have produced and what the promises are and how the promises may not always come to fruition. And one thing that was mentioned to me about the charter school, apparently there's no real requirement or no standard for the teachers to be certified. And I do know that Senator Pacheco filed a piece of legislation in January of this year that puts a moratorium on the creation of charter schools while that is still a practice. I don't have any children yet, but I personally would be very offended if my child's teacher is not certified. My mother's a teacher for over 40 years, and she actually keeps her certification up now. And we must think about that. We have to think about a program that will allow people who are not certified to teach our children. What exactly are they teaching? So I would just ask you to take a look at those things, and if you'd like a copy of the bill, I have it here. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Tony Saunders. I'm the educational consultant and executive director of the Associated Advocacy Center Visions for the Future Incorporated. The reason I'm here today is to tell you a little bit about the charter school. And the reason why I'm doing that is because I represent children with special needs, as I said. I am an advocate, educational consultant here in Brockton, as well as all over Massachusetts. And I grew up here. I raised part of my raising my family was here. And the reason why I left was because of the way that my daughter with cerebral palsy was being treated in the school system. And the reason why we left was because I had to do things like fight for a lip for her to be able to go out to recess with her students, her fellow students. What they were doing was having her walk around the building because she couldn't get into the yard in order to play with the other kids. So I would come from my house and go to the school, Downey School, and I would take my daughter out of her wheelchair, put her wheelchair down that one stair, and then I would play with the other kids, with my daughter, and let the other kids play on the wheelchair. Now, that was my experience. So I became an educational consultant, and I work with students with special needs. So I looked at the Brockton, Randolph, and Taunton district profiles, and I see that approximately 62% of the students in Brockton who are special needs did not pass the 10th grade MCAS. 23% ELA in Randolph, 31% ELA in Brockton, 23% ELA in Taunton, 40% math. So I'm looking at not just the kids who can go to college because they've been in advanced courses. I'm looking at kids that we actually have to create an IEP for, make sure that they're making progress, and allowing them to be able to go to college. And they have that right. I looked at the dropout rate. We're talking anywhere from 13.6, 9.1, ELL students, LEP students, all dropping out 10th and 11th grade. And that's why I'm here, to support the charter school. Thank you.
Thank you for your testimony. Rick Schwartz.
It's this one that works? This one that works? Good, thanks. So my name is Rick Schwartz. I'm a very proud board member of the nonprofit charter school. Sort of fits under the category, I think Harry Truman said, there's lies, there's damn lies, and then there's statistics, which I think you all have heard a lot of. That third category of lies today. But unfortunately, I don't have time to address so many that have been pointed out today. Let me just give my background very quickly so that I can express what my credentials are to be up here for just a couple minutes that I have. I was the staff director of the Mass Senate Committee on Human Services for several years. I was the vice president of a $500 million foundation. And I want to speak to that because I worked very closely with the Gates Foundation when it was doing primarily education funding, with the Met School down in Providence, one of the most imaginative school systems that is now worldwide, with UCAP, which works with kids who would drop out of school because they had flunked. They had missed a year of school. They'd either failed a year or for whatever reason, mostly stuff going on in their families, they had failed a year of school. The Amy Beale School, named after a girl who died in South Africa while she was volunteering there in Albuquerque. And yes, with Omari Walker, who would be the director of this school, who has been the principal of two schools, one in Framingham and one in Fall River, which are brilliant schools. So this school is hardly untested, one of many statistics. I don't know why the Brockton schools have scared you all. Well, yes, I do. It's about money. It is nothing but money that they are scaring you for.
Please address the board.
Thank you. It's nothing but money they have scared them for. So when I dealt with all of these wonderful educators, what they were doing was answering President McKinley, 1896 to 1900, until he died in office. That's when the current education system was created. And we're still doing it. We're operating under the same structure that was created in 1896. Now, if you can think of any other system in America, in the world, that is operating on the 1896 system, big buildings, a teacher lecturing students, no division among the classes being mixed, take sixth graders and eighth graders and let them work with together, I'm sure the wonderful administrators of the Brockton schools will say, oh, no, no, we're doing all that. Statistics. I will see it, I will believe it when I see it. So in closing, I will just say this one thing. If 15 years ago any of these lovely, and I mean it, I loved what I heard about the Brockton schools, and I hope half of it is true. This is a choice. So if any of the folks in this room, and I'm including both sides here, had been asked 15 years ago how they'd like to get their music, how would you like to get your music, they never would have thought about this little box. They'd think about records and then their CD players and then the whatever that other little thing. They never would have thought about something called the iPod, where you could put a ton of music on there and you could pick it by, but you never would have thought it. Well, education is doing that now. Omari, New Heights will bring that here. And they're being scared of choice. No one's taking their bilingual programs. No one's taking any of their programs. You're getting one more choice for imagination. That's what they should be asking for. Thank you.
Great testimony. So I think we'd like next to hear from Craig Pena. Let me also hear from Bishop Tony Branch. And how about Carlos Gomez? Thank you very much. So, first is Craig, is he in the house? Coming up to the microphone.
Good afternoon. My name's Craig Pena, and I'm a parent, a product of the Brockton school system, and a parent of two students at Brockton High. I spoke at a hearing like this a year ago when this same application came before the board and was rejected. Again, at that time, I informed the board that I happen to be from different circumstances than a lot of parents from Brockton. My children attended Trinity Catholic Academy. They received an excellent education there. When my older daughter, it was time for her to go to high school, we had a choice. My family is lucky enough to have the resources. We could have sent her to any number of private schools. We could have chosen school choice to send her to West Bridgewater or to Avon, which is open to every Brockton school, every Brockton family. We chose Brockton High School because children have the most opportunity in Brockton Public Schools. I'm not here to rehash what's been said about the numerous pathways and the numerous opportunities and choices available in the Brockton schools. What I'm here to highlight is the fact that this is a thrice failed application. It's failed for a number of reasons. And the Brockton Public Schools aren't afraid of what New Heights might offer. What I see as a parent is an urban school system that operates on a shoestring, works miracles on a shoestring, and we have a charter school that plans to drain money from a school system and hurt 17,000 other students for the benefit of 600 or 800. That makes no sense to me. Anyone who supports this, people who proclaim that they've supported Brockton children and Brockton families, who supports this, should be ashamed of themselves. Because this just hurts 17,000 students. 17,000 students and their families in the Brockton public school systems. Again, this is a thrice failed application, and I hate to be blunt. Please forgive my language, but you can't shine a turd. There's no other way to put it. Please, I am 100% opposed to this proposal, and I hope you decide against it.
Thank you for your comments. Bishop Tony Branch, are you still here? Thank you. And then Carlos Gomez after that.
Good afternoon, good evening to everyone, and thank you, Department of Education, for coming to the City of Champions today. So that it is clear, although that I am a clergy, I've worked with the poor, low-income, the homeless, and those with food insecurity across the Commonwealth of Massachusetts for the last 30 years, and I'm confused today. I have had family members that have gone to the Brockton Public Schools and have succeeded. Charter schools may have their place, and in some places they're due. But here in this city, we are succeeding. Here in this city, we lead in academic success. Here in this city, we connect with college education, paraprofessional, and technical education. Here in this city, the leadership of our schools is doing very well. Here in this city, we start out with new initiatives. We implement new initiatives. We implement new teaching techniques. needs, and we inspire students. So I'm not sure why we're here today. I'm proud of public education. When I work with these families from the hours of 7 a.m. to 3:30, they see a light, and the light is the Brockton Public Schools. So I want you to let you know today that I am not in support of this charter school. I am a part of the low income. I am a part of the poor, and I am a part of those that have been downtrodden. And I want to let you know that we have done well in this city, and we should applaud the great work that is done in the Brockton Public Schools. Thank you.
Thank you for your comments. Carlos Gomez, please. And could I also, let me see, is it Mozart St. Cyr?
Yes.
Next, and I'm just going to ask you all to kindly refrain from applause. It does take time away from the speaker, and I'm going to add a little extra time. Thank you. Go ahead.
Thank you for allowing me to speak here today. I'm a resident of Randolph, so I'm here on behalf of my kids who I have two school-age kids who live in Randolph, spend 2 hours every morning driving them to schools out of Randolph. So I'm here to support the New Heights Charter School here. I believe as a parent, it's my choice. We get to decide what church they attend to. We get to decide what healthy meals that they have in front of them. So I feel that we need to decide what a form of education that we can provide for the school. Not here to say anything bad about the Randolph Public Schools, but just to let you know that it is our choice, our decisions to make for our kids. And if a charter school is the opportunity that's presented for Randolph, I think it's a wonderful opportunity for the families and the kids. And I don't see how the charter schools in Randolph will take away from the Randolph Public Schools. And I feel it's important that you understand how we as parents feel about having the opportunity to make these choices for our kids. Thank you.
Thank you for your comments. Mozart St. Cyr.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Mozart St. Cyr, and I've been a resident of the city of Brockton for over 25 years. And I'm also a parent of two. And two of my kids tried the Brockton public school system, and then my wife applied for them to go to charter school in Foxborough. And lucky enough, they were called to go to charter school in Foxborough. And one of the reasons why we did that was because I had my brother that had his kids going to the charter school, and we could see the difference between my brother's kids and my kids. And we were wondering why there was such a big education gap between the two. And that's the reason why my wife was very eager to apply at the charter school for our kids. And after we've done that, we've seen the improvement compared to our kids at the charter school in Foxborough and the kids at the Brockton Public School. There is absolutely nothing wrong with the Brockton Public School system. It's just that the overcrowded kids, the many different type of kids that go there for different reasons. It's not about the system that's not good. It's just that there are some parents that are not able to pay for private school for their kids that would love to have would love to have a choice to take the kids to a better school if they can afford it. But unfortunately, some of these parents either have to sometimes even lie in an application to apply for a school out of their jurisdiction, or have to stay in the city and to suffer because they would love to give their kids a better education. One of the things that's very important is the city of Brockton have lost a lot of citizens because they choose to live somewhere else just so their kids can go to a different public school. We would love to keep all of our residents in the city of Brockton. For that reason, a lot of parents either sold the house, leave their apartments, go live at a different town like Easton or Kenton or Sharon, just so their kids can get a better public education. That shouldn't be a choice. You shouldn't have to pay twice of the money you can buy for a house in Brockton to live somewhere else just because you want your kids to get a better education. With a new charter school in Brockton, the kids in Brockton will have a choice. The parents in Brockton that love the city of Brockton will have a choice to stay in their own city that they love instead of traveling back and forth because they have to take their kids somewhere else because they had to move to a different city because they cannot afford to pay for private school. I support the charter school, and if you want to know, you need to speak to the parents. You need to speak to the parents that make less than $30,000 a year, whether or not they would love to send their kids to a charter school. Those are the people we need to speak to, not the lawmakers, not the most privileged people, not the people that have the kids that are super smart already. You need to speak to the people that the parents can afford to do better for the kids. Those are the people we need to think about. If they were to come here, we wouldn't have enough room for them to sit. And we talk up to them every day. They would love to give their kids a better education. For that reason, I do support the new high charter school. It's not about, if you have a question about the fact that maybe there is some fine tooling with the system, I agree. But the fact that for you guys to say we don't need a charter school in Brockton, that's unacceptable. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Sinclair. Let me please have State Representative Michelle Dubois and Deshaun Houston. And is it Mark Lindy?
Hello, and thank you so much for having this hearing in Brockton about the proposed charter school. My name is Michelle Dubois. I'm a state representative here in Brockton, and though I feel as though my actions and how I make my decisions are for the benefit of the whole city, I represent 30,000 people in this city of 90,000 plus residents. And I'm here today to say that I'm not against charter schools, and I really appreciate all the parents on both sides of this issue that have come here and spoke their mind and really let you know what they feel about the charter school proposal, because I think it's wonderful that they care about their children and their children's education, and they're here to let you know how they feel about it. I've read the proposal, and I am against this particular proposal. I don't see it benefiting the school system. I went to Brockton High, and I'm not a cheerleader like some people have come here before. I struggled. I know a lot of children do struggle in the public school system, and it's not easy. And Brockton does need to do some work for children that have issues in large schools and some learning disabilities and social disabilities in the way they are interacting with their classmates. So Brockton does have work to do. But I've read this proposal, and it really doesn't do anything new. It doesn't offer the children something that they can't already get from Brockton Public Schools. And for that reason alone, I have to be against it, because the funding that's going to be taken out of Brockton Public Schools to create and privatize, really, and privatize and profiteer a private company is really not worth the educational loss. So I'm here as a state representative, not just as a person, not as a parent. I'm here as someone that actually has been elected 6 times by this community, so they actually do care about what I think and what I care about, and I want you to know that this is really not good for Brockton, and it's not good for the children that are struggling. I grew up in the home with the parents that didn't graduate from high school, and I am a state representative as a result of the Brockton Public School System. So it is a good school system, and I really hope that you deny this proposal. Thank you very much.
Thank you for your testimony. Mark Lindy. And when you hear your name, please go ahead and line up behind the speaker who's speaking.
Thank you very much for the opportunity to address you. I'm the only person in the room that is representing Southeastern Regional Vocational Technical High School, longest name in the world. I'm a school committee member, and I'm publicly elected by the citizens of Brockton and 9 communities to represent their interests and their needs. Key term is publicly accountable. Charter schools are not publicly accountable the same way that the Brockton Public Schools or Southeastern are. We have wonderful choices in Brockton. I'm a proud product of the Brockton Public Schools, and I would put our level 1 Southeastern Regional Vocational School ahead of any charter school that we're talking about here. There's no teacher certification we heard about in the accountability. You talk about the opportunities for choice and high standards. We have high standards at both of the publicly accountable schools in the Brockton School District. Class sizes would rise dramatically if this proposal changed, because the cuts in the education would take the 35 people that someone mentioned in the classroom and put them to astronomical levels. This is all about the money. They can say nonprofit all they want, but we have public education. I'm a teacher at Massasoit Community College, which is a public education school, and a member of the Teachers Association as well. So I sit on both sides of the table. This isn't good for Brockton. It hasn't been good for Brockton in the past. It's been rejected twice. And to echo the mayor's words, this is a recycled effort by New Heights to add two other communities to the mix. Brockton doesn't need this. Thank you.
Thank you for your testimony. Deshaun Houston, Deshaun Houston. Let me also invite Yolaman St-Pierre as well, next.
My name is Deshaun Houston. I'm gonna give you truth. I'm not gonna give you my opinion. The truth is, today, I had to pick my son up from after I got off of work. He had to stay after school to continue to make up work because they weren't, I stay on him, you know what I mean, regarding his schoolwork. And I had to have him stay behind to catch up on the schoolwork because they don't have enough time within the class to be able to work with him. My son has ADHD. That's a whole different argument in itself. But the problem I had was when I got to the school and I got inside of the office, I asked for them to get my son. They went over the loudspeaker and they asked his name. And the lady that spoke over said, yeah, I let him go 5 minutes ago. So I'm looking at the gentleman in front of me, and he has no idea where my son is. So I'm going, well, where's my son? Well, he might be outside playing. He might be outside, I guess he's outside. So I go to look outside. No, he's not outside. He decides to walk himself home. Do I blame all of Brockton High for that? No. But should I have a choice? Yes. Now, the problem that I have is, I'm from this city, I've been here almost 30 years. I'm a trial court officer. I was also in special needs classes, those who want to find out who I am. I am a product of Brockton High, yes. Is Brockton High good? Sure. But is it good for my son? That's my choice. Do you understand what I'm saying here? It's not a question of whether we should or shouldn't. I want that choice for him. So when I say, okay, well, here's an opportunity that just may suit him, why not? All of this talk about money this, money that, city of champions. Okay, tell me what a champion is. I hear a lot of talk about this city of champions stuff, but I believe the champion is in the heart of the individual who wants to educate themselves and go through those opportunities that what other kids wouldn't be able to have. We could sit here all day and talk about what we disagree with, but guess what? Because of the opportunities that were given to me in this city, I was able to further myself. If you find out who I am, I was on every major program that came to the city of Brockton. City Pride. I was a part of Youth Build. I was a part of Our Positive Posse. All of the major things this city had, when they first built the Boys and Girls Club, I was there. I'm not here to just talk bad about the city, but this is where I disagree. I disagree because my son deserves that choice, and it doesn't matter. And if he does not get that kind of choice, I have to reconsider Brockton. It's just that simple. Thank you for my time.
Thank you for your testimony. Is Yolaman St-Pierre here? Let me also please call Claudia Fernandez, Michelle Hassan, and Belinda Johnson. Go ahead, please.
No, moi c'est Yolaman St-Pierre, moi c'est haïtien.
My name is Yolaman St-Pierre, I am Haitian.
Pour me faire suite ensemble avec monsieur Cécile, ensemble avec l'autre monsieur qui fait que ça parler.
In agreement with Mr. St-Cyr and Mr. Houston.
Également, pas besoin de parler tout ça, m'dabdi, moi, juste faire un résumé.
So I don't have to say everything, I'm just going to give you strong bulletin points.
Moi, je suis là pour me supporter Charter School parce que moi, c'est une maman trois petites.
I'm here to support the Charter School because I am a mother of three.
Et moi, connais qui ça éducation y est.
And I know what education is.
Moi pas ka parler mal de l'école Brockton, de la school Brockton.
I am not here to talk bad about Brockton Public Schools or Brockton High.
Parce que moi connais vraiment vrai ou gain bon professeur.
Because I know that they have good teachers.
Moi connais les vrai ou vraiment haut.
I know that they have high level classes.
Mais m'a demandé est-ce que nous même comme parents.
But I'm asking you as parents.
Qui besoin futur petit nous.
Who care about the future of your children?
Là nous parler de éducation, qui éducation seulement nous focus pour petit nous.
When you talk about education, which education do you focus on?
N'a parlé seulement de matière, mathématiques, physique ou bien l'autre bagaille mais l'autre éducation que petit nous besoin pour réussir demain.
You talk about certain subjects like math and English and science, but what about the education that your child needs to succeed in the future?
Parce que moi-même moi gagne que petit zanmim qui finit dans élémentaire.
I have a friend, a daughter of my friend who has finished in elementary.
Li pa ka aller dans l'école high school Brockton parce que li pè l'école là.
Who cannot go to Brockton High School because she is scared of Brockton High.
Et si maman Timon sa pa gen opportunité pour le payer en private school pour lui.
And if the mother does not have the opportunity to pay tuition for a private school,
ça la fait.
What can she do?
Égal nous-mêmes qui parents qui levé, m'pa konnen gen pile nan nou ki jan de éducation que nous té levé. Mais nous-mêmes qui sorti haïtien, nous connaît sacré les encadrement. Nous connaît sacré les éducation pour petit nous. Si n'a pas les de l'argent, nous connaît quelqu'un l'on soit parent qui voulait former petite li vraiment vrai, senti bon coûté cher.
I can't speak for everybody, but I know as a Haitian person in the Haitian community, we value education. Education is the top priority.
Yeah. Également moi-même là pour supporter l'école Shadow School là parce que gen moun pour envoyer petit yo dans l'école Shadow School yo obligé voyer le dans l'autre city qui pas même gen temps parce que transportation pas bon pour yo faut y aller l'école faut yo gen bay ti moun là si que yo pas ka payer private school pour ti moun là parce que ekonomi ni pas assez si là met ti moun dans l'autre city faut qu'il paye transportation pour lui faut qu'il sacrifie temps et faut qu'il paye plus. Également même moi me dit l'école Shadow School bienvenue dans Brockton parce que là aidé me depuis kounyam getan wè ki côté que a bon différence dans éducation petit moi.
I have spoken to parents and I have spoken to my fellow Haitians who have no choice but to drive their sons and daughters to charter schools outside of the district, which takes time when it comes to traveling and takes away a lot of energy. As a mother, I know what's best for my child, and I can already see that having a charter school education is what is best for my child and would benefit my family.
Également, parents, moi pas ni pour l'autre monde qui pas vle yo, parce que yo gen doit gen raison yo qui fait que yo pas vle, mais moun n'a pas capable dire que qui ça qu'on charter school a vinn faire dans city.
I have nothing against anybody who is for a public school. I have nothing against anybody who opposes a charter school, but people cannot tell what a charter school is going to do to a city before it's even gotten here.
Également même moi là pour me supporter et charter school moi dit le bienvenue et que n'a prétendu. Merci beaucoup.
I'm here to say welcome to a charter school and we're waiting for it. Thank you.
Thank you for your testimony. So could I also have Latonia Francois and Paul Marshall ready to go after we hear from a...
Good evening, everyone. My name is Claudia Fernandez, and I am a parent of a fourth grade student at the Angelus School and a sophomore at the Brockton High School. I have had a good experience with the Brockton Public Schools. They have staff that speak my language. And there are community facilitators that reach out to me. So, I'm sorry, that I can participate in my child's education. I have attended a few workshops in my language, which have been great. I get written translation of notices so that I am aware of what is going on in the school. I support Brockton Public Schools. And I feel that a charter school in Brockton would take away a lot of the services and programs in place. I don't believe that the New Heights Charter School can provide all the services and resources necessary, such as bilingual service, sport, art program, music, etc. If the Board of Education approves the charter school, I will be watching it very closely to make sure they provide everything they have said. If not, I will be contacting the Board of Education. I'm so sorry. I don't speak English so good as I would like, but I will try. I try for my kids. I will try for my community, and I support the Brockton Public School.
Thank you for your testimony. You did great. Michelle Hassan, and then Belinda Johnson, followed by Latonia Francois and Paul Marshall. Then I have a couple of announcements.
Hello, my name is Michelle Hassan, and I am a proud parent of a Brockton High School senior who is already well prepared for college. I'm speaking today in hopes to pay it forward through my support of the Brockton Public School System. My husband and I, and very many generations before us, have got our education through the Brockton Public Schools. Their academic achievement as a model school, Brockton High School has been nationally recognized for more than a decade. This is a testament to Brockton High School's commitment to academic excellence, and they do it through the best qualified teachers, department heads, housemasters, guidance counselors, who I often think are the unsung heroes, the administrators, and of course, the associate principal and principal, and many other valued staff. Brockton High School want their students to succeed. They dedicate themselves to this mission, and it is evident not only to the students, but to their families and the community. Brockton High School has more than 40 clubs and extracurricular activities and 24 sports teams. They truly do care about the whole student. They nurturing and educating their minds as well as their spirit. They understand the importance in celebrating progress, so you can imagine there are limitless celebrations at Brockton High School. They understand the importance in celebrating, through their numerous assemblies where students are recognized for their hard work and success in the classroom, in clubs, and in the sports arena. If you have a passion for an activity that is not currently offered, you have an opportunity to create one. My daughter is an active member of the drama club, and she considers that club to be a second family and home to her. If you want your child to be challenged in their education in the very best way possible, then Brockton High School is the place to be. AP, IB, three foreign language courses are just a few of the ways a student is encouraged to challenge their mind. My daughter will graduate having taken three AP classes. Their teachers really do care, and they do know their students. It is very often I hear how a student or a group of students stay long after the school bell due to a teacher's dedication and care. My daughter is one of 291 recipients of the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship due to excellence on MCAS. We do have a choice for college. As for my own family's personal experiences and those of my daughters at the Brockton Public Schools, we wanted our daughter to have the best education available while having the experiences growing up. Brockton Public Schools have exceeded our expectations. There is always an open door, a listening ear, words of encouragement, helping hands, and much guidance and support that pave the way for your child to experience all the best this great school and its dedicated staff have to offer. Quite simply, the opportunities at Brockton Public Schools are boundless. I wholeheartedly support Brockton Public Schools, and I strongly believe if your child does not attend Brockton Public School, your child will not get the best education. I thank you for your time and consideration.
Thank you for your testimony. Belinda Johnson, and then Latonia Francois and Paul Marshall. And you're welcome to stand behind the speaker. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Belinda Johnson, and bear with me, I struggle to speak. I have a daughter who was in the Brockton public school system who went on to go to a charter school. So I have experience in speaking from both sides of it. One of the things I would say is when people were speaking, I sat back and I listened to a lot of things that were going on. The charter school, a lot of the people talk about costs. We should be afraid of the costs. We should be afraid. People talked about smaller class sizes. Well, these class sizes are about the same. They also talked about teachers. Every year that I was at the charter school, I had issues. Every year I had to fight with something wrong with teachers and things going on at the school. Parents have to be involved with their students, and the only reason why my daughter was able to do well at the charter school is because I am an on-hands parent. I went to the meetings, I've sat in with the boards, the principal, the superintendents, and saw how things work. And we, as residents of Brockton, I understand everybody talking about, they get so excited, they hear charter school, and they think it's the magic, but it's not. If you go to the website and you will see some of the Foxborough Charter School is supposed to be one of the established schools, which it is, but yet the minority students, don't take my word for it, but if you go, they are struggling at the charter school. It's all about who is running these schools, running the schools, who decides how well the schools are doing. If the parents aren't on top and involved, a lot of the students struggle. And the minority students, they've got a whole lot more minority students are at the charter schools up at Foxborough, and they are struggling. And if you go to the website, you will see where they do, how well they are doing at the different levels at different years. And so when I hear everybody saying, well, they want a charter school here, they want a charter school here, the charter school is only going to be as good as the people who are involved at the time. And then when you have issues with a charter school, their word is law. I have facts of problems that I've had with the charter school and took it all the way up to the principal, to the superintendent, all the way to the board. And I was right and documented everything and showed people this is what the problem was. They did not fix it and said that the charter school is an entity of itself and they can do basically whatever they want, and they did. I took my daughter out. I had already spoken to her for a few years, telling her that I was going to send her to the high school, and that she would just, she is doing extremely well. She's an honor student up at the high school, and I was not afraid to send her to the high school. There's a lot more that the school had to offer her, so I had no problem in taking what we did over at the high school. But one of the biggest things everybody needs to stop, yes, you want a choice, but I would love to talk to any parent around here, and I can tell you from experience, I spent 8 years at the Foxborough Charter School, and you don't know what goes on behind closed doors. All you hear is about, it's a charter school, it's doing well. I can tell you from experience, and I can show you facts of the problems that I had, and now I understand. Now I understand some of the parents who left complaining about some of the problems that were at that school. I eventually did the same thing. I had to leave because the charter school wasn't on my side. And anybody that I would love to talk, I will talk to any parent, anyone, and just say, hey, this is what happens at a charter school, you know. And thank you very much for your testimony.
Latonia Francois, Paul Marshall. Are either one of them here? Okay, so let me just, okay, go ahead, please.
Thank you, good evening. My name is Paul Marshall. I'm a resident of Randolph, have been so for 25 years. I'm here to speak kind of in a unique way. I am a public educator. I have been so for the last 25 years. Started in Mattapan, then went to Framingham, was in Fall River for the last 9 years. Many of my colleagues are in the audience right now, and I have the utmost respect for them. However, I'm here to speak in a different manner. My experience in Randolph is my first two children were able to go through the public school system and did very, very well. My third child coming through, the handwriting was on the wall. Money was short, and frankly, he did not have the same opportunity as my other two. So we had to make a hard decision of taking him out of public school. And by the way, I'm not only a public educator, so was my wife. So we took him out of public school and put him into private school. We were able to cobble together the money to make it work, so we were very lucky because we had that option. Additionally, I'm speaking on behalf of the charter school because I know the people who are behind the charter school. I worked with them extensively when I was in Framingham as well as in Fall River. And I can tell you from experience that these folks will hold themselves to the highest of standards because that's the way they have approached their work in public education from day one. They believe in the students that all students can be successful, but some students aren't successful yet. And they took that premise and put that to work both in Framingham as well as Fall River and other communities. So I can tell you that I am for choice. It's a difficult thing for me to stand up and say that. I was a principal in Fall River for 6 years, and I understand the other side of that. So really what it's about for folks is money. If this wasn't about money, I can tell you right now, my colleagues probably wouldn't be sitting in the hall right now because they would be saying, hey, you know what, let's give it a shot. So I am for choice. I believe this is a good choice for the Randolph citizens and Randolph students. So with that, thank you for your time.
Thank you for your testimony. I'm going to call a few people up, but then I'm going to make a couple of announcements before we hear your testimony. Nadine Ciceron, Turville Valer, and Bob Sullivan, Brockton City Councilor. So, but before we go on, I know a lot of people have come in, and I just want to say that we are timing everyone. Everyone gets 2.5 minutes, and the timer goes off. You get another 30 seconds. We hope to wrap everybody up after the 3-minute mark. So please be ready to just finish your sentence when you hear that timer. Better if you can finish up a little before then. We have at least 22 people signed up, and we are supposed to be here till 6 o'clock. So my colleagues are in agreement that we will stay for 20 minutes longer and to hear a little more testimony. So please be considerate, and we'll try to keep your remarks as concise as possible. So Nadine, are you here? Nadine, come on down. And Clerval, I'm sorry if I'm mispronouncing, Clerval Valer. And folks can come down. There's plenty of seats up front. And then City Councilor Bob Sullivan. Thank you. Go ahead, please.
Hello. My name is Nadine, and I'm from Haiti. Among us, all good education is always the most valuable riches. We cherish that as gold. For us, I have a son. He's 1.5 years. Next year, he will start school. And since school in my country, it's my first experience as a parent, and I also want a good education, a good beginning for my very smart boy. I would like to use my voice to the other parents asking you about thinking about a kindergarten for the youngest, like my son, because all I can recall from my parents in Haiti, they always said the earlier is a good education is the better for life. And also, I would like to say that I really appreciate the thought that you're thinking about a charter school in Brockton. I'm not against those people who think that high school, public school, or Brockton public school, they are also good. They got good teachers. They are working hard for our kids. But from Haiti, our education, the one that we're giving our kids at home or at school, we asking about a standard, about something that is more higher than that. Because as I can remember, I got a 7-year-old niece at home, and she's really, really smart. And I can say that the program that they are attend to give her in her school, Kennedy Elementary School, so I think it's a little on low level for her because she's so smart. She always been like, why do I have to do this when I already know it? But I think that every parent have to make their own choice for their kids. So what I can say, I really do appreciate the thought of a charter school in Brockton, and I cannot wait to have the charter school in here. And thinking about it again, We would like to have a kindergarten for our youngest because the earlier start for good education is the better for our community. Thank you.
Thank you for your testimony. Clairville, Valair, moving on to City Councilor Bob Sullivan.
Good evening. First of all, I want to thank you for coming to Brockton, and I want to thank everybody for showing up here. I mean, it's obvious everybody is passionate about kids, right? I'm a husband and a father of three young kids, ages 8, 5, and 3. I've been on the City Council 10 years. I do want to echo the sentiments of many of my colleagues. I'm a councilor at large serving the entire city of Brockton. I've never once been asked to be an advocate for the charter schools. I came before you last year to speak against it. I'm here again tonight to speak against it. I am a proud Brockton graduate of public schools. I went on to Boston College. I have a law degree and an MBA. Why do I have those? Because of the foundation I got through the Brockton Public Schools. And that really is to the teachers, the men and women that go every single day to the Brockton Public Schools to teach the youth. I used to be the town attorney over in Randolph for 5 years. I'm familiar with that community. My nephews go to the Taunton High School. I'm familiar with that community. But I really I'm concerned about Brockton. It will have a negative impact on the financial ramifications of the city of Brockton. We get shafted under Chapter 70. We have for many years. That's why there's the McDuffie case, the Webby case, and the Hancock case. But if you look at the Chapter 70 funding, this will decimate it. Right now, we're on a shoestring. We're working with what we have, what we do with what we have. And ultimately, if this is granted, and I don't think under Mass General Law it should be granted, and that's why they sought the waiver last year. But really, what they're trying to do is a redo, a replay, a bite of the apple by adding other municipalities. My humble opinion, that's not fair. I do appreciate everybody that's here today to say that they want choice, but we have choice. We have private choice, we have parochial choice, we have vocational choice, we have the Edison Academy, we have the Champion. But I'm concerned about the ramifications it's going to have on the students, because it will have a ramification, negative impact on the students and the morale of the teachers. Brockton teachers have worked extraordinarily high to get us over that 10% threshold. We have done that, and we're excelling. And we're excelling. And I think at the end of the day, you need to listen to two people. You can take into account everybody that spoke today. But I really think Superintendent from Brockton and Taunton summed it up the best. They really do. That's what their job is every day, to fight for the students and for the faculty. And they did that today, and they expressed to you. So in my humble suggestion, this is not the right proposal for the city of Brockton. It's a business, a for-profit. Nothing against those that want to try to do that, but not to do it here in the city of Brockton, because it's not appropriate for the city of Brockton, and it will have dire consequences, not for the present, but really for the future of the students of the city of Brockton. I want to thank you all for coming, and I wish you all a happy holiday.
Thank you. Testimony. So let me just have Jessica Harvey, followed by Anne Ferrioli, followed by Natasha LaForest. Jessica, are you here? Doesn't look, yes? Okay, thank you. And the other two, if you can be ready, you can either take a seat up here or stand behind the speaker.
Hello. I'm Jessica from Taunton. So she kind of put me on the spot, kind of nervous. I'm just a mother, and my daughter goes to the middle school in Taunton. I feel as though like the charter school won't affect her because benefit for her because she's doing great. She moved from Hudson, and at first she was against Taunton schools. She did not like it. She did not want to go there. We had a fight for her all last year. Now that she's in Taunton schools, she's doing much better. She likes it. She feels as though like she met friends, she's comfortable, and I have a son that has like ADD, and he was doing bad, and now like the teacher that he has this year, she's a great teacher. She's awesome. Like she goes above and beyond for my child, and like I feel as though like the charter school is gonna take from them and it's gonna set them back. And then they're gonna fall back into the patterns of where they're not liking the school and the whole situation. I'm kind of nervous. And Lynn, she's awesome. Like, she helped us a lot. And Taunton Public Schools is a good school system. And they have wonderful teachers and advocates, and they helped my family a lot. Like, we come from low class, and you know, we don't have a lot, and from us moving to Taunton, I feel as though like we're gonna start a good family, and they're going to do good in their school systems out there. So now I'm kind of stuck in Taunton, and I don't want to move. At first, we was going to move because we didn't like it. But now we're comfortable, and we like it, and I feel as though like that won't benefit them at all.
Thank you for your testimony. Ann Ferrioli.
I'm going to give my time to Omari Walker, if that's okay.
You can say I pass. It doesn't matter. Yeah, we have people who are signed up here. Do you pass?
He will get an opportunity.
Yeah.
Oh, get an opportunity. Then I will talk. My name is Ian Ferrioli, and I'm an education advocate coordinator. I work mainly out in the southeast. I work for the Department of Children and Families. I work with a lot of the kids that we're not talking about tonight, unfortunately. I'm hearing a lot about the 97 or 92% of kids going to college, and that's absolutely fabulous. I'm not against public school. Obviously, my own children go to public school. I went to public school. But I am for choices. And I'm talking for the kids who aren't here today, whose families aren't here today, because they can't be here today. I'm talking about the kids who aren't part of that going to college. I'm talking about the kids who aren't even in those statistics because they dropped out of school, or they're homeless, or they've moved out of the area. Those are the children that I work with, that I see every day. I also want to go back to what Mr. Marshall said. I've worked with the people of the New Heights, Omari Walker and Janice Manning out of Fall River. I have to say, most people don't like to see an educational advocate come to the table. I know you're very surprised by that, but I was welcome in their school. They would ask me to come in for meetings, ask me to be part of meetings as to what they could do better to help the students that they had. That doesn't usually happen. That never happens. And it was a good experience with them because they were concerned about what the kids got for services and keeping the kids who couldn't function in a big school system. And not to take it away from Brockton, but Brockton is a big school system. My own children would never be able to function in such a big school. It's about having choices. It's about having things that work for individual children. I don't think that just because you live in a particular town that's the only school system that you have to go into. It doesn't work for everybody. So I'm speaking for those who the big public schools is not working for. I'm not speaking for the 92% that went to college. Thank you.
Thank you for your testimony. Natasha? And then let's have Michael Dodry, and David La Civita following that. Please go ahead. Welcome.
Hi, good evening. My name is Natasha LaForest. I'm a parent of a seventh grader. Her name is Arielle. She's been a student at Pluff Academy since the sixth grade. She transferred from a parochial school to the Pluff when I discovered that there was an international baccalaureate program right here in Brockton. This program is well known around the world for its rigorous and challenging curriculums. I know about it because I'm first generation Haitian. My parents, they always talked about that was the system that they had. I never really understood it. It's a number system. It's backwards to me. I grew up here. But when I read that they were offering an IB program, and it was free, because usually they're for the affluent, I wanted to give her the opportunity to be a part of a program like that and to expound her horizons and her experiences. I was a bit nervous about sending her to a public school, as she had never been to one before. So I called and I reached the principal, Ms. Nasrallah, who reassured me that my daughter would be okay at school, and that there were several other students who would be from Trinity actually leaving and going over to the Pluff. Well, not only is Arielle okay at Pluff, she is flourishing. She loves the IB program. On her first day of school, she handed me a sheet of paper, like a list that lists all of their IB learner traits, and she has this pinned up in front of her desk on her bedroom wall. She strives to be inquisitive. She strives to be a thinker, communicate well, take positive risks, be knowledgeable, have principles, be open-minded, and care about others, and be well-balanced, and also reflect on the events in her life and the lives of those around her. She loves that she has the opportunity to learn Mandarin and learn about Chinese culture. She now likes to make small talk with our dry cleaner because he speaks Mandarin. Arielle never wants to miss a day of school. No matter how much I try to convince her to take a day off, I'm a nurse, so sometimes during the week I have a day off and she says, no, I'll see you at the end of the day. She enjoys every single day of school. She enjoys helping out in her community. The IB program strives community volunteering and doing something to improve the community. So she is an altar server at our church. She enjoys not only learning math, science concepts, but actually applying those concepts in her STEAM class. She gets to actually do what they learn, what they read about. What my daughter really enjoys is the mutual respect that the adults and students have for one another. A charter school in Brockton is not needed. There are many, many, many choices in the city. They offer each middle school, each elementary school, the high school. They all offer wonderful, challenging, a variety of things. And I just feel like the charter school would strain the limited resources that the city already has. We have wonderful, hardworking, educated, talented teachers that work with very limited resources and produce fabulous, fabulous
Thank
students.
You. Thank you very okay. much for Thank your testimony. You. Thank you. Michael Dockery. Thank you. Followed by David LaCivita or Civita.
How are you doing? My name is Mike Dockery. I don't know where to start. I live in Brockton for about 20 years. I own properties in Brockton, Bridgewater, and Boston. Both of my kids went to Brockton High. I think the school system is a great school system, but the administration is lacking. Last year, my son was 15 years old. We had a major incident with a school. Found out the Brockton Police School Department was Brockton Police was making false reports against black students, well, minorities, showed it to the administration. They chose nothing about it. All the city councilors and the school reps, they all know about it. I told them they did nothing about it. I called the Board of Education for Washington, D.C., and also local office at the FBI. They took an interest. I'm for the charter school. The reason why, I've seen the same issue that's going on now happened in Boston about 20 years ago. And they try to stop it, but to me, it's like the horse and buggy theory. You could keep on trying to try the horse and buggy, but eventually the cars are going to come. So they could fight, but they can't stop it. And people that say that the charter school, they failed once last year, the year before, it doesn't matter. If at first you don't succeed, try again. Now, my son, last year when the incident happened, he was 15 years old. This kid been in over 20 different countries, been to China. It's been England. This past summer alone, he was in Germany, was in Switzerland, Austria. Over there, there's not an issue with the school system. There's not an issue about rich, poor, black, white. But for some reason here in Brockton High, these people use the government money to only educate, well, try to help the white kids versus the black kids. I found tons of family, tons of kids, and that's not right. Now, with a charter school, there's more oversight. You can come in there, you can say, okay, it's only a charter school, the board is smaller, the class sizes are smaller, we could investigate it quicker. In Brockton High, they could try to push push the kids around and play with the numbers and try to get more funding and stuff like that. What else can I say? I'm for the charter school, and I said, if at first it don't succeed, try again. You can't stop a moving train as long as they have the momentum and the right people behind them, they will succeed. And like I said, I'm talking to people in Boston, I'm talking to people around the country, trying to do something as far as making big changes. Thank you.
Thank you for your testimony. David, followed by Robert Connolly. And Sheila Manley. Thank you. Go ahead.
Good afternoon. My name is David Lasavita. I am a father of a third grader at Hancock Elementary School. I am a member of the PTA. I am in opposition to the charter school. I support the public schools. We've had nothing but a great experience there. When Superintendent Smith got her job, I talked to my aunt, Nancy Souza, who was an employee in the public schools for quite a few years, and I said, so did they pick a good one? Are we in a good place? And I will quote my aunt. She said, David, she will work tirelessly for your child. I can't believe anything else. I've seen her at my PTA meetings three or four times a year, and she's got, I don't know how many schools that she has to go to. I'd like to thank Tom Minicello as well. He's been to, I believe, just about every PTA meeting that we have. And the reason I'm talking about the elementary schools is because I think they're being underserved in these meetings. I know that the charter school is looking at middle school and high school kids. I think there's really no question about it that Brockton High School services the community perfectly well. Nationally ranked, recognized as one of the best schools in the country. If we're not performing in the top 10%, if we're not performing as well as, I know we're out of the 10%, I don't know where we are right now, we're not at the bottom 10%. So I wonder why the charter school is not looking at the elementary school kids. I'm pretty sure that the English language learners are concentrated there. It's my understanding that the English language learners students are more expensive to teach. And I think it's unfortunate that a charter school could probably be successful if they were willing to open up their doors to the more expensive students to teach. It just doesn't make any sense to me to go after the students in a top school in the country thinking that they're failing you. And for the people here who've chosen to send their children elsewhere, I can't imagine how difficult a choice that must be. Because when my wife and I were looking for homes in the area, we could have afforded houses in the Bridgewaters, not Easton, unfortunately. We could have afforded houses in a lot of other cities and towns in the area. There was no question we were going to buy a house in Brockton and make sure our child or children got their education through the Brockton Public Schools. I want to thank you again, Superintendent Smith, Tom Minicello, and everyone from Brockton Public School who's here. I appreciate your work. Thank you very much. Thank you for your time.
Testimony. Robert Connolly.
Good evening. I'm Robert Connolly. I'm the Associate Pastor of Dominion Church International, which is right behind the Conference Center. Real quick on my credentials. I lived in the city for 26 years myself, and professionally I've worked with children my entire life. Substitute teacher in the Brockton Public School Systems for about 4 years, worked in the Boys and Girls Club, worked in the YMCA as a street outreach worker, and currently I'm a director of a community center in the Brockton City. So I've always worked with kids, and also obviously at the church as well. Being in the city, I grew up in the city when there was only 4 junior high schools. And now we're at a point where we have elementaries that we have to turn into junior high schools as well, simply because we have grown as a city. And I reject the fact to think that if you are for the charter school that you have to be against the public school system here in Brockton, because I don't. I would be a hypocrite if I do. I'm a graduate of Brockton High School, also a graduate of Massasoit as well. Love the school system here, but I just simply feel that because of the size of our city, it's growing, it's continued to grow. Many people come here because they love this city, that we need more opportunities. And I don't really feel that the fight is against New Heights. I feel like the fight is against charter schools. And I don't see the danger in adding an option for the city to have their kids go to a place of their choice, whether they want to go to a public school or send their child to a charter school. I think the charter school brings another, sorry, I'm fighting the cold, brings another opportunity for the residents here, and they can simply choose. And I think if you look around the United States, that charter schools does have a high record as well. So once again, I don't feel like the fight is just against New Heights, but against charter schools overall. And if you give the city an opportunity to have a charter school in the city, we will see that more balance and we can be able to spread out, because I don't think Brockton High, the Champion Charter and the B. Russell can hold all of the kids that we are putting into these high schools coming from these junior highs that we didn't have when I was in junior high. And that's all I just wanted to say on that subject.
Thank you for your testimony. The last three speakers, I'm sorry we don't have more time to go on, but our last three speakers will be first Sheila Manley, or Hanley, from Randolph, Tom Minichiello, Vice Chair of Brockton School Committee, and wrapping up will be Omari Walker.
Yes, thank you. I'm Sheila Hanley. In Randolph, the district I recently retired from, $2.9 million is siphoned off from the district and directed to charter schools. This is a significant sum of money from a district that has long been under-resourced. I know, for I spent 32 years there. Randolph's strength is its diversity. It is a very urban-like district. It has the highest African-American student population in the Commonwealth. It's also a district where 36% of the students' first language is not English, and the same percentage is listed as economically disadvantaged. Educators in Randolph celebrate that diversity. But as a district, Randolph can't afford to provide busing for students, nor can parents afford to pay for busing through fees, as other districts sometimes do. Sometimes this causes students to come late to school, prevents them from attending after-school support sessions. Both of these impact student learning. Randolph also is not able to keep the class sizes optimal, primarily, again, because of funding and space needs as well. Randolph has laid off occupational, physical, and speech assistant therapists due to funding constraints again, and now caseloads of those specialists have increased considerably, and consequently, meeting the needs of those students has been severely compromised. There have been delays as well in hiring other specialists. Many parents are happy with the public schools, and yet are concerned about class sizes and services being cut. What districts like Randolph needs is additional funding, not less funding, to meet the needs of its unique, wonderful, diverse population. School systems in urban areas need to provide more outreach and family wraparound services. We know that some students come into our schools with gaps in early readiness skills because preschools are not available or affordable for all families as they are in more affluent districts. Do not dismiss the work of urban educators and suggest that they are failing students and that the answer is more charter schools. To remain vibrant, urban and urban-like districts need financial resources and support of its existing district schools. We do not need another charter school pulling students and financial resources from Taunton, Brockton, or Randolph. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your testimony.
Good evening and welcome to Brockton. My name is Tom Minichiello, and I'm the vice chair of the Brockton School Committee. More importantly, I'm a parent of a sophomore at Brockton High School, and my oldest son just graduated last year and is very successful in college. He was at the top of his class. My second son is in the top of the class. The Brockton Public Schools had well-prepared Matthew for college, and Greg is doing the same. Some in the state have said they don't understand the loud opposition from Brocktonians. It's quite simple. The overwhelming majority of parents and taxpayers view the Brockton Public Schools as the crown jewel of the city. Our high school and middle schools perform extremely well. As you heard, we get all sorts of awards. There's all sorts of choices for our students. There's choices inside of the district. There's choices outside of the district. They already exist. I can assure you that Brocktonians have extremely high expectations. And if they weren't satisfied with the Brockton Public Schools, there would be an overwhelming outcry for an alternative. They would welcome an alternative. They would welcome New Heights. They would basically say, hey, the system's not getting it done. The public officials in this room would say, we support an alternative. Our constituents are telling us they're not happy. The district's not doing it. But guess what? That is not the case at all. Our biggest asset is our teachers. Our teachers are so dedicated and have all of the mandated licensures. They're an extremely talented group of people who deal with issues that no other district deals with. And we're very fortunate to have them. The financial reality is basically this. Like many said, we're working on a shoestring budget. In Brockton, we try to provide our students with academic excellence, with access to learning materials, with access to technology. Digital literacy is so important. But we're at a disadvantage from the suburbs. It's a reality. We don't have the resources that they have to provide these kids with what they need. And we still get it done. Imagine that. Somehow we still get it done here in Brockton. But providing another unnecessary charter school that no one really overwhelmingly supports, you know, simply a few, is going to, again, carve off those resources that we so desperately need. And it's simply going to increase, as you know, we've had a layoff here in Brockton. It's going to increase our class sizes. It's going to provide us with less resources to provide those extracurriculars that we so desperately want to provide but have a hard time providing right now with regard to theater, music, band, sports. You know, we try to do it all with less. And I can assure you that if there was a clear need for this in Brockton, this would be packed with people screaming for change. It's not. It's an outside group that's coming in and basically says, look, we should have choice. Well, choice is nice.
Thank you for your comments.
All right. Thank you.
Omari Walker. You're our final speaker.
Thank you for the opportunity to speak. This is not a debate about charter schools and public schools. This is not about being a nonprofit or for-profit. This is not about being a private school or a public school. What we are offering is a free charter public school option. Not a private school option, not a for-profit option, a free charter public school option. All families deserve a choice. You've heard that time and time again. Our model is simple. We will prepare all of our students for college, period. Under our model, we will serve grades 6 through 12. We have a strong relationship with Massasoit Community College. Under our model, 100% of our students will start college classes in the 9th and 10th grade. 100% of our students starting college in the 9th and 10th grade, and the majority of our students will graduate with an associate's degree when they get their diploma, high school diploma. This isn't an untested model. Early college high schools have been around for more than 30 years. We have developed this model in conjunction with EdWorks. EdWorks is a subsidiary of KnowledgeWorks. It's a national educational organization. EdWorks has more than a decade of successfully implementing early college high schools. We aren't here to compete with Brockton, Randolph, or Taunton either. I'm sure their schools do a lot of good for a lot of students. What we're simply offering is another opportunity to have a first-class early college high school opportunity in the city of Brockton to serve Randolph, Brockton, and Taunton families. We talk about Brockton or there isn't a desire for parents here. We have over 600 applications. I don't know if that's ever been done pre-approval, but 600 applications. Parents are choosing us. We're ready for this task, we're ready for this challenge, and please give us an opportunity to open a first-class school in this community. Thank you very much.
Thank you for your testimony. Thank you to everyone who came out tonight. I apologize, I'm sorry we just didn't have time to get to everyone. You are more than welcome to submit any comments up through Wednesday, January 6th to the department. That would be to the Office of Charter Schools and School Redesign. So thank you very much for coming out. This meeting is adjourned.